May I talk with you a moment? Let us reason now together. Let's put aside our differences and pause. Let's promise to each other that we speak in love and kindness. I come with no agenda, but to share a higher cause. So often it is said that we are all God's little children. The thought of hell makes many scoff or laugh. But I am here to share with you the truth that we've been given. By nature, we are sinful, and we're all children of wrath. Created in God's image, yes, but fallen through rebellion, we turned away and chose our degradation. The will of man rejected God and severed our communion. So now, instead of fellowship, we're born in separation. Spiritually dead to God, we do not serve our Maker. The intents of the heart are full of self. Although we were intended to honour our Creator, we chose to turn our back on Him and live to serve ourselves. None can claim their innocence. It's clear that we are sinful. The truth of our demise we can't erase. For if we say, I have no sin, we make our God a liar. All have fallen short and must receive His gift of grace. This is why our Saviour came in reconciliation. Christ died upon the cross to pay for sin. Unto us a child was born. God's gift was freely given. His love has made a way that we might all return to Him. Whoever should believe in Christ can now receive His pardon. A child of God has Jesus as a friend. Whoever has the Son has life, escaping condemnation. Yet Jesus shows us clearly that we must be born again in spirit, by accepting Christ as Saviour, for sinful man cannot be one with God. By nature, we are dead to Him, for though our heart is beating, we only have eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Good works will never save us. This thought is a delusion. The law of God will make our conscience squirm. No one can attain the mark or earn their soul's salvation. From dust our flesh was made, and to the dust it will return. But God has placed eternity within our very being, created so that we could dwell with Him. We only need to view the cross to see God's righteous judgment. We must accept that Jesus paid the wages of our sin. This act of love, so wonderful, will save us from all judgment. Our fellowship with God, He will restore. For Jesus is the greatest gift. Through Him, we know the Father. Born again in spirit and a child of wrath no more. There is no other way to God. No other name can save us. For only Jesus died and rose again. Please ask yourself wholeheartedly, do you know your Maker? He longs for you to know Him as your Saviour and your friend. He wishes none should perish, but come to their salvation. When angels sing for joy with great applaud, considering the glory that awaits for all His children, why would any soul choose hell before their loving God? Why would we reject His grace, His mercy and His pardon, estranged from God, alone and set apart? Why choose a bitter destiny when we could have redemption? Don't waste another moment, but receive Him in your heart. His hand will be upon your life. His Spirit will anoint you. Become who He intended you to be. Enjoy the full, abundant life of knowing Christ as Saviour. Become a child of God for life and all eternity.